In today's tutorial, I will show you how to configure TPA on an OnTurn server. Firstly, we will show you from where you download the plugin and then how to install it, adding permissions, which means not only admins can TPA, but normal players can use it as well. And we will explain all of the configuration options as well. First things first is that we have to download the plugin. To do this, you need to go to restoremonarchy.com and head over to the plugins page. From here, just search for teleportation. Over here, there are two plugins, which one of them is for free. The difference is that Teleportation 2 has more options, but the free version is good enough. And from here, all you have to do is just hit download. After this, you would need to extract the plugin. From this, just click on extract all and you will get a new file. From this, go to your server console page. From there, navigate to servers, OnTurn, Rocket and plugins. Open the file explorer and drag and drop teleportation.dll into plugins. From this, go back to console and restart your server. The next thing that we will do is adding permissions. Once the server has restarted, you can check to see if the plugin has actually loaded. From here, the TPA is already on the server, but to let every player use it, you need to add permissions. From this, go to File Manager, then Servers, OnTurn, Rocket, and open permissions.config.xml file. This is where you have to add your permissions. You will need to go to ID, default ID in the file, and this is where the default permissions group, which means that every player will have these permissions. By default, each player has permissions to P, Compass, and Rocket plugins. P is a command that displays a list of permissions to a player, Compass is a command that tells them the direction that they are looking at, which is pretty useless, and Rocket command displays the current version of Rocket on the server. Alright, let's get back to the topic. We're currently adding permissions for TPA. You can go back to restoremonarchy.com to look at the description there to see if it has the list of permissions. As for teleportation, it only has one permission, which is the same as the command name, which you will find it on the plugin page, and from here all you have to do is just copy it. From there, go back to the permissions file and paste it after the last Rocket command. If a plugin doesn't have a list of permissions on their description, they are probably the same as the command names. For example, for home, it would just be home. From there, save the file and go back to console. You don't need to restart the server to apply the changes, just type preload command in console. Now I will show you in game. Firstly, you can do the /p command and TPA is on the list, and we will test the command. If you'd like your TPA to have a waiting time, it is called the TPA delay, and I will show you how to change it when we are in configuration. Next, we will go over configuration. From here, you would go in Rocket plugins teleportation, and here open teleportation.configuration.xml file. And now we will explain each configuration option one by one. Firstly, let's go to message color. And this is just the color of the message sent by the plugin, and this could be any color that you would like. Next, let's go over to TPA cooldown. This is the time before the player can send another TPA request, this time in seconds, so if you type 15, it means that it'll take 15 seconds. Next we have TPA delay, which this is the time after the TPA was accepted by the player who sent the request has to wait before he will be teleported. Next we have TPA duration. This is the duration of time the TPA request is valid, and the player who received it can accept before it expires and has to be resent. Next we have allow cave. Now if this is set to false, like it is by default, players won't be able to send TPA requests for underground. For example, bunkers on Holman Island. To disable this, just set it to true, so this allows player to send requests from caves. Next we have allow raid. If this is set to false, players will enter raid mode when they damage other players' bases, and they won't be able to send TPA requests until it expires. Next we have raid duration, which is the time in seconds after this last time that a player damaged another player's base before raid mode expires. Next we have allow combat, which players enter into combat mode when he shoots another player. It works the same as allow raid. You must set it to false to actually enable it. Next we have combat duration, this time in seconds, the same idea as raid duration. Next we have use unsafe teleport. When set to false as it is by default, it prevents players from glitching under the map or into bases using the TPA command. Next we have cancel on move. If this is enabled, during the delay time, player won't be able to move or his TPA will be cancelled, and he won't be teleported. The max distance player can move without cancelling the TPA. As for this, I recommend setting this to a higher value so it doesn't cancel when a player moves only a little bit. For example, setting it to 5, it should be just fine. After this, save the file and restart the server. Some plugins may support Rocket Reload command, but it will break most of them. So it's a good habit to just restart the server after making any changes to plugin configurations. I hope that you guys did learn something from this tutorial, and if you need any help or have any questions, you can always comment below or join the Discord, which will be linked in the description below. And thank you so much for watching.